Welcome to Iconic Movie Reviews, and today I'm going to be reviewing one of my absolute favorite movies, and that is John Wick 2. Chapter 2. So this movie stars, of course, Keanu Reeves and Common, and a few other actors in this movie. This is probably, to me, one of the best action movies out there. Obviously, Keanu Reeves does his own stunts, and it's directed by Chad Stahelski. And if you don't know who he is, he actually spent his time learning about Jeet Kune Do, had his own academy in California, and then he spent time as either a stunt coordinator or a stuntman. And the first time he really got recognized was when he actually was a stunt double for Keanu Reeves in Matrix Reloaded. So that was kind of his first introduction to Keanu Reeves. So they hit it off really well. There is a little bit of an influence, of course, in this movie, a little bit of Jeet Kune Do, a little bit of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, obviously lots of gunplay. Chad actually spent some time as a stunt double for Brandon Lee in the movie The Crow. So it's kind of interesting. There's one scene in John Wick 2 where it actually feels like a throwback to Enter the Dragon. And I think maybe that was a little bit of a tribute to both Brandon Lee and Bruce Lee as well. So you get that feeling in this movie that Keanu Reeves is the Bruce Lee of today when it comes to action movies. And this guy, Keanu Reeves, spent a lot of time training for this movie. You can find him on YouTube training with the Machado brothers, and as well as training with guns, all kinds of weapons, that kind of stuff. And I think that's what I really enjoyed about this movie, was the realism in it, as real as it can get, from the perspective of John Wick never misses anybody, but that's just how good he is. And yeah, it plays a little bit like a Western, a modern Western, that kind of feel mixed in with martial arts, all that kind of stuff. But what I like about it is the stunts are, I would say, as realistic as you can get. And what do I mean by realistic? There isn't any green screens per se when they're fighting. It's not like a superhero like Iron Man versus Thor or that kind of stuff. It's actually hand-to-hand combat. And what I like about it is you can actually see what's happening within the frame. There's other movie franchises like Bourne Identity. I didn't like that series, Jason Bourne, all that kind of stuff with Matt Damon, because it felt like the shots were too close and it was all the shaky cam stuff. And well, anybody can fight then. But when you pull the camera away and you actually see Keanu Reeves taking guys out, doing hip tosses, arm drags, arm throws, joint locks, joint manipulation, all that kind of stuff. And then, of course, finishing off with a shot to the chest, couple shots to the head, kneecaps, whatever it is, knives, whatever. This guy is a lethal wrecking machine, and I loved it. It was very poetic when it comes to a movie. I know sometimes it sounds weird because this movie is very violent, but man, is it very poetic. I just loved it. It makes you feel like this is just beautiful. It's gorgeous. It's like painting a canvas filled with violence, I guess. But I loved it. I loved the stunt work in it. It was just absolutely fantastic. And Chad Stahelski, again, he actually was part of the second unit for Captain America. So any of the secondary shots that they had to do, stunt work, that kind of stuff, you can kind of feel the similarities, especially when you see Black Panther go against the Winter Soldier, Captain America taking on George St. Pierre at the beginning. Like, there's all these little fight scenes that you can actually see them fighting. And I really love that. And I actually like this one just as much as John Wick Chapter 1. Now, a lot of people are like, well, it doesn't have as much of a story, or maybe it's too in-depth. Chapter 1 was very basic because guy comes in, kills his dog, and steals his car, and then now he has a purpose. This one has just as much of a purpose in this movie because John Wick, in order for him to accomplish this impossible task just before John Wick, he actually ended up helping the Russian mafia become who they were, and it was all because of the foundation that John Wick laid. And what I liked about it was he actually asked for help, which was one of the Giordano, one of the Italian mobs. He basically signed a blood oath asking for help, and this guy helped John Wick out to complete this task with a condition that one day this guy will come and ask John Wick for a favor. And in this movie, of course, he asks John Wick to kill his sister, and which leads Keanu Reeves down the road. He has to go to Rome to take this woman out, and he has no choice because it's a blood oath. And that's the beauty of this movie, is there are rules, and once you know what the rules are, you have to live within these rules, good or bad. Common. Let's talk a little bit about Common, and then I'll wrap this up. I think this is one of Common's best action roles because he goes toe-to-toe with Keanu Reeves in it. And I like the one of the scenes where they first meet, and they know each other from a past life, I guess. And Common says to John Wick, he's like, "Hi, John, you working tonight?" And John Wick says, "Yeah, I'm afraid so." And Common asks him, "Was it a good night?" And again, Keanu is like, "I'm afraid so. I'm afraid I had a great night," which means he actually assassinated Common's ward, which right away they go toe-to-toe, and the action sequences, man, you could just watch this over and over again. I love it. I can't wait for John Wick 3. I think it's going to be fantastic. If you haven't seen this movie yet, I encourage you to watch John Wick first, then watch the second one, and then, of course, I'm going to buy the third one as well. It's going to be awesome. And Ruby Rose does a good job as well in this movie. She's great, a great actress, and, man, she is a force to be reckoned with. Not quite as tough as John Wick, as you'll see in this movie, but I think she did a great job. She never says a word. I don't know if she's deaf or if she just can't speak, but she uses sign language throughout the movie. So, but yeah, I love this. I thought this was fantastic. So there you go. So there's my review of John Wick 2. Have you seen this movie yet? Are you going to see it? What are your thoughts? I think this is an absolute iconic movie, and I give this movie a 10 out of 10. So thanks for watching.